Welcome back to another episode of Toy Therapy. I'm the host of Toy Therapist, aka Matthew Anton. Today, as you can see, I'm looking at a Star Wars Black Series figure from the archive line, and I'm looking at, finally, I've got him, Clone Commander Cody, and this figure is being very elusive in my collection. When he first got released back in, I think it was the blue box, the black or black with the blue background. At the time, I had different rules about collecting figures, and now since I've broken, and now I'm collecting the commanders and so on, and the troopers, I could never get this figure for a decent price. He just goes really, really, really high amount. I mean, I think he was retail for £20, £19.99, and I'm seeing him go for roughly about nearly the £100 mark. He is a very hard character to get. But anyway, let me just quickly go through the box. So you're getting a really nice picture of Cody. Bring that a bit closer there. Looks really nice. And it's part of the Lucasfilm 50th anniversary, which I do find a bit weird that they're doing a Lucasfilm 50th anniversary and they're not doing any other figures from other franchises like Indiana Jones. I just find that a bit weird, but it's still nice nonetheless. The back of the box, you get a nice close-up there of Cody. And if you want to read about the burb of him, then you can read that burb. You can press pause. Another thing I do like as well, it gives you a bit of a timeline as well over the 50 years, what they released and so on, which is actually quite a nice touch. I do like that. Good movie-like timeline. And there's no Mandalorian mentioned, which is a bit weird, but still a really nice box. I love the archive line. I actually do like the archive line. The only thing I don't like about it is as soon as you open it, you can't really put it back together again, like the old boxes. But anyway, I'm an unboxer, and at the moment, I always burn my boxes. People might go, ooh. But every time I burn the box, I always play that montage music from Return of the Jedi when Luke is burning Vader as well. So that's what I do. But anyway, let's get to the figure. As you can see, I've taken Cody out of the plastic prison, and it is a lovely figure. It is a retool in some ways. But anyway, before I do anything else, let's go through the accessories. I was a bit shocked, really, because they've done a re-release, they could have added, I mean, they don't have to, but they could have added the Order 66 hologram Sidious. That would have been quite nice just to put in, maybe. But I'm going to look in to see if I can get one of those myself. But accessories-wise, you're getting his rifle blaster. It's like his heavy blaster. Really nice quality plastic, nice and clean. But I am going to do a bit of dry brushing, and I'm going to put just a little bit more detail in there just to pick it up a bit more. And as well, you're getting his actual blaster. So nothing new there. Standard weapons for the cloners. But anyway, this is what it's all about. Okay, like I said in the before I did the unboxing, I'd never got Cody. He's one of those elusive figures. He is a retool of a couple of figures, basically, like Gree and I think it's Fox as well. He is just like a bit of a variant of all the other different clones. But obviously the paint system as well, and that's a bit new there for him as well. But it is a great figure. I'm glad I finally got him. I'm hoping at some point they might do like a pack with all the clone commanders. Maybe just do some little bit extra with them. Or even from the Rebel Star Wars Commando as well, the Commando unit. That is something I'm waiting for. They made an appearance in their own game as a first person. Then in Star Wars Battlefront 2, they made an appearance in there as well. I'd love to get that as a figure. Really would love. And have that Commando unit. That'd be quite cool. But anyway, let me go around the articulation. So you're getting a really good head swivel all the way around. And you're getting a lot of play on the old head there, on the old neck joint as well. You're getting a really good rotation there, and you're getting a swivel on your bicep, and you're getting a really nice elbow joint there as well. Really nice. Same with the other one. You are getting a bit of a twist. I love that noise. Really do love that noise as well there. Okay, you're getting a bit of a swivel on your thigh, and you're getting a really good movement there as well. Same with the knee joint. Really nice. Mine's got a bit of a splash of red or pink there. I'm not sure what it is. I think it's pink, but I don't really care. And as well, you're getting a really good foot tilt and up and down movement as well. So you're getting all the standard posability from the other troop, from the other commanders and clone troopers. Nothing really new at all. It is just a re-release of the original figure, which I've been waiting for the last like couple of years. Basically, once they started doing the archive line, I knew they would do this particular figure. At the moment, they look like they're always doing the figures are quite expensive, and I'm hoping as well at some point they will go to do some ones from the like Cal Kestis and the Second Sister as well. That'd be quite nice. But anyway, I can gush about other figures. This is not what you come to see. So let me just go through the paint applications. They really have made it a lot more, give it a bit more definition, especially in the armor compared to the other troopers. The paint finish is really nice. The helmet is exquisite. Really nice finish on the helmet. Just the detailing. And as well, you are getting his like his backpack. You're getting some of his other bits of equipment. I just love the detail of the gun on this. The paint finish is really good. It's one of the best painted troopers I've seen in a while. Right up there with the Incinerator Trooper and Commander Wolf as well. Those three troopers are like up there for me. Really are. Same with even the Stormtrooper Commander, the blue as well. Those are my favorite troopers at the moment. But it's just the detailing, the finish, the painting. Just look at that detailing as well with the grenade there as well. Mine's got a little bit of bleeding, but not too much. Like I said, I can easily get a bit of paint and sort that out myself. I even have thought about even putting a bit of black oil sort of wash in there as well, just to make that pop a bit more, because it looks a bit too clean for my liking. I'm going to have to double check the source material and have a look, just to compare. But just the small touches, like as well, mine, that's a little bit, you can see a lot of the molded yellow plastic. I'm just going to top that up. It's little things I can easily do myself as well, but overall I'm really impressed with the finish on this guy. It's just the chest piece is really nice compared to the other troopers as well. It's got a nice feel to it. They might have changed the type of plastic, which I'm not that bothered about. It feels really good in the hand. And I'm just literally in awe. I'm glad they're doing older figures, because I'm not really into the collecting for, say, yes, I've got this Holy Grail figure, because I don't like the word Holy Grail. I think Holy Grail is something that you can never, ever get. I just feel that Hasbro are just doing a really good thing, what they're doing with the old archive line. They're bringing some new figures in. They're doing some figures you can't get. Then they had as well the big reveals on Friday. They're doing Guido. They're doing an original Obi-Wan from the first release as well, with like his orangey like red gowns with a brand new face sculpt, which looks brilliant, which I got on order. And they got Qui-Gon Jinn and another battle droid, and as well they're re-releasing, which is just weird, Jar Jar Binks. Roughly for the same price without the shield, the energy shield. So I can see the reason why some people are a bit annoyed about that. Most of us will get Jar Jar Binks at some point. I'm just not in a big rush to get him yet. But there's been quite a few reveals lately on through Hasbro. So, and I'm really enjoying what they're doing. Like I said, my favorite line at the moment is, which I'm getting a lot of enjoyment out of, is the gaming greats and the archive collection. That is where I'm just really enjoying what they're doing. But anyway, this is my Commander Cody review. I hope you liked some of the insights, not to what my collecting has been like at the moment, but to other figures that's coming up. So hopefully I might do my top 10 figures in my collection, what I bought over the last year. I mean, I'm seriously thinking about doing something like that or doing something a little bit different, but I might even just start doing my top anticipated characters, which I would like to see released. But anyway, this is Toy Therapy Sound. Until next time, thanks for watching. Please give me a like, share, subscribe. That'd be fantastic. And thank you again to the new subscribers that come to my channel lately as well. It's been really, really nice to see my channel grow a bit more. I'm nearly at the 200 mark, and I would like to get to 200. Everywhere I'd like to get to that 1,000, but I'm a long way off. So anyway, so thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you guys and girls soon, and stay safe, and thank you for watching. Bye-bye.